Today, we are going to be talking about my top 5 favourite games that I played in 2020. Now, this is going to be a list on older titles. So if you want to see the games that I played that were new titles that released in the year of 2020, check the description box below, as this video will be revolving around games that were a little bit older and released a few years ago, or maybe even older, but I still played them in 2020. So number 5, Little Town Hero, a game that a lot of people hated for the combat, as it was RNG based. Basically, it's like rock, paper, scissors. It's extremely luck based on what abilities you or your enemies draw out, kind of like a game of cards. But I found it extremely addicting and I just could not put this game down. It's also made by the same people who made Pokemon, so that would probably explain why it's so colourful and nice to look at. One nice thing about this game as well is there is actually no grinding required, as there is no level system. There are skill points that you can put into abilities and stuff that will help you out if you do struggle, but you don't really have to grind very much at all. The boss fights can be quite difficult though, and some of them did take me a few attempts. The story is very light-hearted, and it's basically just about a boy who wants to venture out into the world, but he is not allowed to leave the town. But there is a little bit more to the story than that, and I recommend trying it out for yourself. Number 4, Fire Emblem Three Houses. A fantastic game, but you really need to have the time available for it, because it can take up to 200 hours to even get the full story. That's a heck of a lot of time. The game has multiple different branching routes that will slowly feed you the story over the course of each route. There are so many characters in this game that it can be slightly overwhelming at times, but I really enjoyed learning about each character and had tons of fun figuring out which characters I wanted to develop my relationships with. It has a ton of social elements, but the combat is also quite fun. It's a grid-based battle system that requires some thought, especially if you are playing on the harder difficulties where your party members can permanently die. Scary stuff. Number 3, Judgment. Another Yakuza game, but this time it is a spin-off. Instead of playing as a member of the Yakuza faction, you play as a detective that is trying to investigate a mysterious string of murders. Like all the other Yakuza games, it had the wholesome and wacky side quests that you would expect, with a really interesting crime drama. The girlfriend system was also really well done and the best I have seen in a Yakuza game so far. Number 2, Horizon Zero Dawn, and also the Frozen Wild DLC, I played that too. While it took me a while to get this one, I can understand why the game is so popular. Working out how to take down all the machines in the game is extremely satisfying. It can also feel extremely intense at times when taking down the really huge machines, and I found myself really needing to concentrate, otherwise I might end up meeting my untimely demise, especially at the beginning of the game. The story was really compelling. I found myself saying just one more quest before bed, just so I can uncover more of the secrets that remain shrouded in mystery in Aloy's past. Exploring the cauldrons was also a huge highlight for me, as they really made me feel like I was in another world. I'm extremely excited for Forbidden West, and I'm hoping to stream it once it releases. Da-da-da, number 1, of course, is Dragon Quest Builders 2. You all know that this would be here somewhere, right? Dragon Quest Builders 2 is a spin-off Dragon Quest game, but does kind of continue on from the original Dragon Quest 2 game. Imagine mixing Minecraft with Dragon Quest. The story and characters are just as fantastic as the first game, but with even more items and features. I think they did an absolutely fantastic job of this game, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I have my fingers crossed in the hopes of a sequel, or even just more Dragon Quest games in general. Honorable mentions! The ones that didn't quite make the list. Astral Chain. This game is a little bit weird, honestly. But it was also really interesting. I think the story in some parts were a little predictable, but the combat was really fluid and satisfying. You basically control robot stands and they are attached to your character on chains. There are quite a few different robots that you can get throughout the game, my favourite being the dog robot because he's awesome and you can ride him. So cool. Each robot can help you in different ways to traverse the environment, so they are not only useful in combat, but they also are useful in the world of Astral Chain. The world of Astral Chain can be quite mysterious, but I didn't really feel very attached to very many of the characters. I felt like the combat was excellent and I loved the detective parts where you can search for clues and whatnot, but the characters and story felt a little bit weak at times, but overall I really enjoyed what the game offered. New Super Lucky's Tale! A really cute platformer that felt great to play, is very bright and colourful, and overall just a really relaxing, enjoyable experience. It also had a few puzzles thrown in to mix things up, which was really nice too. Two Point Hospital, a game that almost made the list due to the nostalgia of playing Theme Hospital back in the day. I love the really silly illnesses that the game has come up with, and a few of them made me chuckle out loud. However, the game can get a little bit repetitive after a while, and I did get a little bit bored in some parts, but I'm so glad they decided to bring this game back as it holds some very dear memories for me. Pokemon Sword! The reason this one didn't make it to the top 5 list is because I played so many amazing games this year that Pokemon Sword just didn't quite make it. Honestly, I actually enjoyed Let's Go Eevee more than this game, but I put that down to the nostalgia of the original Pokemon. As everyone knows, Pokemon is repetitive, they all are, and I did feel it a little bit while playing, especially when I got to Rose Tower. I really didn't enjoy that part of the game, but the gym challenges, the wacky new Pokemon designs, and the wild area were fantastic, and I really enjoyed my time conquering max raid battles with friends. Last but not least, Unavowed. I would say that this game was actually my hidden gem. It was a game I played on a whim, and I ended up enjoying it way more than I thought I would. It's a point-and-click game with pixel graphics, and you can choose to be male or female. The story revolves around you being possessed by a demon, and you must join a secret supernatural organization with people who have similar afflictions to you in order to find out what is going on in the world. There are multiple dialogue choices, and your decisions do actually affect what happens in the game. A fantastic little game that had me engrossed all the way through, so well done to the creator for this one. I really did enjoy it. That's it for my list. There's quite a few games there. I had a really hard time choosing between the games that I did play, but I hope you enjoyed. I just want to say a huge thank you to all of my Patreons for supporting the channel. Thank you so much, and if you are interested in donating, there will be a link in the description box below to my Patreon page. It's only $1 a month to gain access, and I am currently uploading exclusive anime review videos only on Patreon. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I hope I'll see you next time.